Hello students, let us continue with part 2 of realization of structures. In this, another typical example I am solving. This example is asked in January 2019 question paper, where y of n is given. In this example, y of n is equal to 0.75 y of n minus 1 minus 0.125 y of n minus 2 plus 6 x of n plus 7 x of n minus 1 plus x of n minus 2. If you notice from the previous example where h of z was given directly and you had found different structures, but here y of n is given. Try to understand difference equation or y of n is given. The first step is to find y of h of z. Hence, applying z transform. Okay. What I do is I just take this y of z is equal to 0.75 z raised to minus 1 y of z minus 0.125 z raised to minus 2 y of z plus 6 x of z plus 7 z raised to minus 1 x of z plus z raised to minus 2 x of z. Okay, I have taken all the things into z domain. Now separate out y and x. That means y of z minus 0.75 z raised to minus 1 y of z plus, I have taken all these things to the other side of the equal sign, plus 1.125 z raised to minus 2 y of z is equal to 6 x of z plus 7 z raised to minus 1 x of z plus z raised to minus 2 x of z. Correct. Now I will just make y of z outside so that it becomes 1 minus 0.75 z raised to minus 1 plus 0.125 z raised to minus 2 is equal to x of z outside 6 plus 7 z raised to minus 1 plus z raised to minus 2. Correct? That's what is the equation here. Now I have to find y of h of z. H of z, which is output y of z divided by x of z, isn't it? That means I just make y of z here and bring the denominator x of z. This goes to the other side. Hence, y of z divided by x of z becomes equal to, y of z divided by x of z becomes equal to 6 plus 7 z raised to minus 1 plus z raised to minus 2 whole divided by 1 minus 0.75 z raised to minus 1 plus 0.125 z raised to minus 2. Okay, this is what is the h of z. This is h of z. Correct? H of z is equal to this one. Now, I shall implement different structures on this. Okay. I shall implement different structures on this. Right. Once you've got h of z, you can implement or realize different structures like direct form 1, direct form 2, etc. let us have direct form 1 structure on this. Direct form 1. I shall do it here. Direct form 1 structure. How you do direct form 1 structure? Just you know that direct form 1 structure, you have to have the input side at the input point. Hence, I shall have delay elements z raised to minus 1. Two delay elements are required, z raised to minus 1. Okay, and then what you do is you just see to that, you see to that b naught, b1, b2 are implemented. B naught is equal to 6, rest all I am not writing. 7 and 1, hence plus plus. I want 2 summing points. This becomes the input x of n. Similarly, output. See, output point I will just take. Output point I will take. That is y of n. And how many delay elements are there? Output side, 2 delay elements. Z raised to minus 1. Z raised to minus 1. Okay. And then this 1 is correct. Intact. Then I shall have minus 0.75 is there. A1. Here what happens? It becomes minus of minus. That means plus 0.75. 0.125 is there. When it transferred to structure, minus 0.125. Hence, here one summing point, here one summing point. Joining these two, this middle point is W. If you want to put, you can put there. Hence, this is direct form 1 structure. Okay. Now, what about direct form 2 structure? See, direct form 2 structure is very similar to this, swapping the output to input and input to output and central delay element. Hence, I start here, you know that I start here with the central delay element point. How many delay elements? 2 delay elements. Z raised to minus 1. Z raised to minus 1. Okay. And outputs are the input element. That means, if you want to put directly from here also, you can see B0 is equal to 6, then 7, and then 1. Okay. And 2 summing points. This is my output y of n. Now, input side output or denominator equation. Here it is 1. Then 0.75 and then minus 0.125. Summing point and summing points. This is my input x of n. Okay, input x of n. Hence, this is direct form 2 structure. I implemented direct form 1 and direct form 2. Keep it again in mind that when you are transferring the denominator equation or output equation, this should be 1 and rest all negative. This should be 1. It is there. Minus of minus 0.75. Minus of 0.125. Minus 0.125. This transferring is very important. Let us go ahead with the cascaded and parallel structures. In previous board, we have seen that y of n was given or difference equation was given. We have found out h of z and then implemented form 1 and form 2 structure. And I have written the corresponding h of z, which is as for the given equation. Now, let us implement cascaded structure. You know that cascaded structure, h of z, whatever is there, no? You want h1z multiplied by h2z. This kind of equation is required. Hence, I need to factorize this. Factorizing is required. Hence, let us take numerator equation, which is equal to 6 plus 7 z raised to minus 1 plus z raised to minus 2. Now, you know that factorization, you should go to equation mode and then degree. Okay. What is the degree? Second degree. Okay. What is A here? A is 1. B is 7. C is 6. Hence, you are having z raised to minus 1 is equal to minus 1. And another equation is, both are real, z raised to minus 1 is equal to minus 6. Try to understand that this z raised to minus 2 becomes my second order. It is like x square. Ax square bx plus c. Now, you are having two roots, z raised to minus 1 is equal to minus 1 and z raised to minus 1 is equal to minus 6. Now, as I told you, you should see to that you take this to the other side. I have explained all this in one video, but anyway, I will continue explaining in this video also. This goes to the other side, hence it becomes 1 plus z raised to minus 1 is equal to 0. Goes to the other side, hence it becomes 6 plus z raised to minus 1 is equal to 0. It is there in the form of 1 plus something raised to z raised to minus 1. But this is 6 plus z raised to minus 1. Hence, what I do here is further divide by 6 throughout. Divide by 6 throughout. Because the first term, whatever is there, that must be 1. Hence, I divide. Divide by 6 here. Hence, 1 plus 1 by 6 z raised to minus 1 is equal to 0. Hence, numerator, polynomial, whatever is there, it gives me in this form 1 plus z raised to minus 1 multiplied by 1 plus 1 by 6 z raised to minus 1. This is what is the factorized form of the numerator. Now, let us take the denominator. Denominator, polynomial, whatever is there, it is in this form. 1 minus 0.75 z raised to minus 1 plus 0.125 z raised to minus 2. Now, you know that again A becomes 0.125, B becomes minus 0.75 and C becomes 1. Hence, A is now 0.125. B is minus 0.75. C is 1. Hence, I got z raised to minus 1 becomes equal to 4 and another z raised to minus 1 became equal to 2. But how I have to do is take to the other side, hence it becomes minus 4 plus z raised to minus 1 and this became minus 2 plus z raised to minus 1. But as I told you, I want something 1 plus z raised to minus 1 form. Hence what you have to do, you have to divide by minus 4 here. When you are dividing by minus 4 throughout, what happens is 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 1. Here, I have to divide by minus 2 throughout. Hence, it becomes 1 minus 1 by 2 z raised to minus 1 is equal to 0 is equal to 0. Hence, what is the factorized form? D of z. Denominator becomes 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 1, 1 minus 1 by 2 z raised to minus 1. That's what is the denominator. Now, h of z, which was of this kind, I have factorized it and written in the form 1 plus z raised to minus 1 multiplied by 1 plus 1 by 6 z raised to minus 1 whole divided by 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 1, 1 minus 1 by 2 z raised to minus 1. This is what is the factorized form. Now you see, this factorized h of z, whatever is there, I have to have it as h1z and h2z. Now let me consider, see this fact, whatever is there, no? I will consider it as h1z. And the next, whatever is there, I will consider it as h2z. This is h1z and this is h2z. Now, h1z and h2z I have to implement. I will be, generally while you implement cascaded and parallel structure, we will go directly with form 2. Okay. Now, h1z I have to implement. They are coming in series or cascaded form. First, I will implement h1z. I will take a central point, central point, and how many delay elements? One delay element here, z raised to minus 1, and then this input side 1, next it is again 1 and 1 coming output side, this is 1, it is correct, and minus 1 by 4 is there, it becomes minus of minus, hence it becomes 1 by 4. This is plus and this is plus. This is x of n input. Now the next structure. To implement the next structure, I will just take the central point. Again h to z implementation. I am having one delay element at z raised to minus 1. Now implementing input 1 and then here 1 by 6. Okay, and this is 1, that is correct. And minus 1 by 2 is there, hence it becomes minus of minus, hence it becomes 1 by 2, plus 1 by 2. Okay, and one summing point required here. I implemented h to z also, this is the output. Join these two. Now what is there? This is completely h1z and this is completely h2z implementation. Okay, let us see parallel structures. I have rewritten h of z. Once you are obtained h of z, you have to see the order of numerator and denominator. What is the order of numerator here? The order of numerator is 2 because it is z raised to minus 2, correct? What about the order of the denominator? Denominator order is also of 2. See, parallel structures are implemented with the help of partial fraction expansion. So as to apply partial fraction expansion, I want numerator polynomial should be less than denominator polynomial. What is the numerator polynomial here? It is 2. Denominator is also of 2. We can't apply partial fraction expansion because 2 is not lesser than 2, isn't it? If it was first order, then I could have implemented partial fraction expansion. So as to implement partial fraction expansion, I have to convert this into a proper fraction form. What I do is, first you see I have to divide numerator with the denominator. For that, first I will write it in the form z raised to minus 2 first. See, z raised to minus 2 plus 7 z raised to minus 1 plus 6 divided by I again 0.125 z raised to minus 2 minus 0.75 z raised to minus 1 plus 1. Okay, I am dividing. Now first I have to cancel out z raised to minus 2. I have to cancel out z raised to minus 2. For that you have to see that 8 is the factor. How you get 8 is this 1 divided by 0.125. 8 when you are multiplying, you got z raised to minus 2, then minus 6 z raised to minus 1, 8 into 1 plus 8. Now it became minus plus minus, cancels out this, 7 plus 6 13 z raised to minus 1, 8 minus 6 minus 8 minus 2. Hence h of z, which is there, no, h of z, which was second order equation divided by second order equation, I am converting it into 8 plus 13 z raised to minus 1 minus 2 whole divided by see 0.125 z raised to minus 2 minus 0.75 z raised to minus 1 plus 1. Like this I am converting. Okay, you again note that this is already factorized. The denominator second order equation is already factorized, isn't it? Hence I can again write this h of z, which is equal to 8 plus 13z raised to minus 1 minus 2 whole divided by 1 minus 1 by 4z raised to minus 1 1 minus 1 by 2z raised to minus 1. Why I am writing this in this form? Because this is factorized already. In the previous board you have seen that this is factorized in this form. Now whatever equation is there now here, whatever equation is there now, this is a proper fraction. It is, I can have a proper fraction expansion for h1z. Now h of z, whatever is there, h of z, 8 plus h1z, 8 plus h1z. What is h1z? A proper fraction. How I got proper fraction? By dividing denominator with a numerator with a denominator. But like this you have to divide and you have to convert it into a proper fraction. Now let us see h1z. Use partial fraction on of h1z. Okay, now I will only consider h1z. H1z which is equal to 13z raised to minus 1 minus 2 whole divided by 1 minus 1 by 4z raised to minus 1 1 minus 1 by 2z raised to minus 1 is equal to a divided by 1 minus 1 by 4z raised to minus 1 plus b divided by 1 minus 1 by 2z raised to minus 1. Now I have to find a. To find a. What do you do to find a? You know that 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 1 must be equal to 0. This implies z raised to minus 1 must be equal to 4. Correct? Z raised to minus 1 equal to 4. That is already a root of z raised to minus 1. Now, h1z or how to find a is, you know that in this equation, 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 1 goes. Hence, I am just finding out a. A becomes equal to 13 z raised to minus 1 minus 2 whole divided by 1 minus half z raised to minus 1. 13 z raised to minus 1 is 4 minus 2 divided by 1 minus 1 by 2 z raised to minus 1 is 4. 4 by 2 is 2 to 1. 52. 50 minus 1 is equal to minus 50. A became equal to minus 50. Now let us go to find A. To find B, you know that I have to use this 1 minus half z raised to minus 1 is equal to 0. This implies z raised to minus 1 became equal to 2. Now I have to put z raised to minus 1 is equal to 2. Hence B becomes equal to, in this equation, 13 z raised to minus 1 minus 2 whole divided by this goes, and I remained with 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 1 is equal to 13 into 2 minus 2 whole divided by 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 1 is equal to 24. Okay, 1 minus half, that means half, became equal to 48, right? B became equal to 48. Hence, this implies me that h1z, which is equal to a means minus 50. Minus 50 divided by 1 minus 1 by 4z raised to minus 1 plus b, 48 divided by 1 minus 1 by 2z raised to minus 1. Now I have to see to that h of z is written again and I have to implement the structure. Let us see it in the next board. Okay, I have written h of z again, which is 8 plus h1z. H1z was a proper fraction which was implemented using partial fraction expansion, and you found A to be minus 50 and B to be 48. Okay, now we are in the last stage. We have to implement this structure. Very simple. First, let us see 8. 8 means you have to have simply a line with 8. Then I have to implement the second here. Minus 50 divided by 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 1. How to implement? How many maximum delay elements are there? Here in this second, there is maximum of 1 delay element. Hence, what I do here is z raised to minus 1. Okay. And then I am having minus 50. And this 1. Minus 1 by 4 is there. Minus of minus. Hence, it becomes 1 by 4. The second structure here is implemented. And the third, 48 divided by. How I implement? Again, I will put a central point and one delay element. One delay element. And then this is input side 48. No other structure. And this is 1 and minus half whatever is there. Minus of minus half. Hence it becomes plus half. There is one point here. Now I just join this. Join this. Now you know that all the three inputs whatever is there, no? All the three inputs whatever is there, they are having common, that is x of n. What about the output? Output you have to bring it to a common summing point. You have to bring it to a common summing point, and from there you have to take the output. That's how the parallel structures are implemented. I hope I have given the details in the previous board or previous video session. Hence, this becomes my output y of n. This is how I have implemented parallel structure. Please note that parallel structure, I have seen first the numerator and denominator. Because they are of equal order, I can't apply partial fraction expansion. I divided, okay, and then make it or converted it into a proper fraction, and that proper fraction part whatever is there, I used partial fraction expansion so as to find a, b, whatever, and then I rewritten h of z in this form, and then I implemented parallel structure. I hope you understood. If any doubts are there in say factorizing format, or why I divided numerator and denominator, and why I rewrote h of z, etc., if you are having doubts on those points, you can just discuss that, or you can call me over mobile, or you can discuss this point on your group. Okay, thank you. Actually, I have completed module 3 and 4. Next video session onwards, I will be dealing with module 5. If you are having any doubts in module 3, 4, like we have implemented Butterworth filter, Chebyshev filters, impulse invariant transformations, bilinear transformation, all these things. Okay. Any doubts in module 3 and 4, you can contact. Thank you.